Hi, Valerie Dawn here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Electric Quilt 8 to determine the overall size of your quilt that you're designing in EQ8 and to how to use its fabric calculator to determine the quilt fabric yardage. We'll also use Electric Quilt 8 to calculate the backing fabric yardage. Let's get started. This is a quilt I once saw on display and I really liked it. This is a very traditional Lone Star pattern. I have used Electric Quilt 8 to redesign this quilt and here it is. Now when you're in Electric Quilt 8, what I want you to do is click the layout tab. I'm using the Apple version. The Windows version will have the same tabs. Go to layout. And this is telling me the size of the quilt's center layout is 76 by 76. That's the inside dimensions here. I've added a border to the outside and also another narrow border to represent the binding. To see the overall finished size of the quilt, you look down here at the bottom, you'll see finished quilt size 85 by 85 inches. And the layout tab. This one is 4x4 blocks. Each one of the inside blocks is 16 inches by 16 inches. And you'll note you can click this and make sure that Electric Quilt will keep the width and the height equal. Now the sashing, I can also click that to say keep the width and height equal. And so it's 4x4. So when it's saying the width and height, it's talking about the vertical sashing. Versus the horizontal sashing, and these are 4 inches. If you'll notice, it says include sash border. If I click that, it adds the sash out here. I've decided not to do that. I'm simply going to have the sashing on the inside, and then I'll piece a very plain border around the outside. So to add the border, we go to this tab, and this is a horizontal, long horizontal, which only means that the top and bottom are longer than the vertical border. And this border again is 4 inches all the way around. And the size of the quilt including this border is 84. Again, I've added this outside narrow border that's 1/2 inch to represent the binding. So the total size of this quilt will be 85 by 85. I have pulled the Lone Star block from the Electric Quilt library and placed it in each one of the blocks, and then I placed the fabric in the sashing and the border. To calculate how much fabric I need, you simply click the Print and Export tab, and then you click Yardage. It defaults to 44 by 45 inches, which is usually around 40 to 42 inches of usable fabric. Most of them are about 42 inches wide that you can use, and I'm calculating it with a 1/4 inch seam allowance. I like to preview this so I can see it before I print it on paper. And I can zoom in on this, so I'm just going to click zoom in, and then I'm going to drag all the way around that, and it will show me the yardage estimate for each fabric. Now, remember to buy more than it calls for, because if you make a mistake or you want to add more later, after you start working on the quilt, you'll have the additional fabric. So always buy extra. So the background white, light color, it says 2 7/8 yards. Well, I would obviously round that up to at least 3, and I'd probably buy 4. And the dark blue is 1 1/8. Again, I probably round that up to 1.5 yards. This one is 3/4 of a yard, and I would round that up as well, maybe 1 1/4 yards. I will just point out with these two, there's this little symbol here, this pound sign, that has a note related to each one of these fabrics. The estimate for this fabric assumes that long strips are pieced. What they meant by that, and I will just close and cancel, these long strips, it's assuming that you're going to have a piece, you're going to have a splice in them, because your fabric will not be wide enough for this. And I will zoom in, zoom what it's talking about that's going to be pieced is this border, the narrow binding around the outside. So let's go back to the yardage calculator. Preview and zoom in again. So you can print this off and take it with you to the fabric store and buy additional if you want. Now, the next thing we're going to look at is how can you use Electric Quilt 8 to calculate the backing fabric. What I do is I create a new quilt layout. This is 85 by 85. I'm going to create a new quilt, horizontal, and then I'm going to go to layout and I'm going to say there are two horizontal, one vertical. All right, so I've got two horizontal blocks. I'm going to delete the border. Just take that right out. I don't need a border. Go back to layout. Now, what I'm actually gonna do, I'm gonna have different size blocks. So I'll uncheck keep width and height equal. And my width is of each block is going to be 42 inches. And my height is going to be 85. So what I've actually done here is I'm showing you the backing that I would have to piece down the center for the backing if I buy fabric that is the 42 or 44 inches wide. And I would have to piece it together. Now, to do that, you have to adjust a setting in Electric Quilt 8. There is this gear here, which is work table settings. When you click it, it opens this options window. Go down to layout options, all styles, maximum size of blocks. And the largest I'm allowed is 100. So you have to adjust that large enough to accommodate that I've got this large piece in the backing. It restricts me to 100 inches. So if your backing's 108, then you'll have to add a few inches extra. I very rarely have a quilt that's larger than that. So let's set that to 100, click OK, and that will allow me to create blocks that are 42 wide by 85 high. I add it to the sketchbook, go to design, and I still need to fill this with my fabric. I'm going to use this light color. When I do find the fabric I want, I'm going to use that on the backing as well. So you just fill it in there, put it in the sketchbook, and then you do the same thing. Go to print and export, yardage, and I'm going to say it's the 44 inch wide fabric. I will preview, and then I can zoom in. And it's told me I need 6 yards. That means 3 yards, and you'll have to cut it at 3 yards. And then piece the two sides together. Remember to cut off the selvages in the center. I will have 3 yards of fabric for this side and 3 yards for the other side. If you can find extra wide quilt backing fabric, sometimes you can find fabrics that are 108 wide. Let's do another quilt. My finished size block will be 85 by 85, which is the full size of the quilt. I can then go to design. I will fill it with a backing fabric color. Go to print and export. Instead of saying 45 width, I'm going to select 108 because it gives us an option for the extra wide fabric. So click that and I'm going to click preview. Now zoom in so I can see what it's telling me. It is saying if I have 108 wide, I would need 2 3/8 yards. Well, let's round that up to 2.5. That would be 36 by 2.5. That's 90 inches. I would have a 90 by 108 inch piece of fabric for the backing. So you can see how you can use Electric Quilt 8 to calculate your fabric for your quilt top and your quilt backing. Hope this has been helpful. Thank you for joining me with this Electric Quilt tutorial. And you will find a link to Electric Quilt in the description below. Thank you for watching and happy quilting.